Imagine the day, the time, the moment that Jesus comes back. Now, is Jesus going to appear with a bag in his hand? Isn't he going to put his hand into the bag and pull out some vials of pills and say, "Brothers and sisters, God has sent me back into the world to bring you this medicine that you so desperately need. Here's some medicine for cancer. Here's a pill for Ebola. Here's something for your arthritis. Here's a pill to make you happy." Is that how it's going to go down? When Jesus comes back, is he going to bring anything? Is he going to bring a bunch of money here, passing out money to everybody, pills, books? What's he going to do? Didn't he say when he comes back, he's coming back to round up, gather those who so desire to go to his place and hang out at his place, stay, dwell with him at his place? And when he left, he said, "This world is not my place. It's not my place at all." So Jesus is not coming back bearing pills. He's not a pill pusher. Jesus is not a pill pusher. Okay, he's not coming back with a sword and getting on a white horse and saying, "I'm going to go over there and demolish, you know, the bad guys and the girls, and I'm going to take care of all your enemies. I'm going to slaughter everybody." No, he didn't say that. He said, "I'm going to gather up the faithful, those who are prepared, who want to go to the dwelling place I have prepared for them." Okay, so don't expect Jesus to come back with a cure for cancer. Okay, Jesus represents supernature, the true, which is reality, the reality. Now, we let this sink in for a moment. We are waiting for some sort of cure, but we don't realize we're waiting for it to come from nature. That's why we're waiting. That's why everyone's waiting. If you were to look at the one family that we are in spirit, you'd see everybody's like waiting, just sort of like motionless, just waiting. What are they waiting for? They're waiting for a cure from nature. Now, nature, the idea of nature, the delusion is that there's a process. So we're waiting for an outcome, something to help us. We're waiting for a pill or waiting for something. But of course, everything keeps shifting and changing in nature. And did we ever consider maybe we should just ask for something that's supernatural to happen? That doesn't depend on nature. It doesn't depend on the seasons. It doesn't depend on the sun, astrological configurations. It doesn't depend on your situation, where you are, how old you are. It doesn't depend on anything about nature. It's perfect right now. Okay, supernature is perfect right now. And it stays perfect. So all we have to do is ask supernature to come on the scene, help us out. It's always perfect in supernature. And supernature can help us out, because actually, nature is a hallucination. It's a hallucination that we're clinging to, and we're afraid. But we can loosen up and say, "You know what? Supernature, come on in. Come on in. Come on in like a breeze. Come on in like a breeze." The breeze is always fresh. The breeze from supernature is always pure and fresh. Don't have to wait for some cloud formation. Don't have to wait for some pressure system. Don't have to wait for some weather front to bring this fresh breeze of supernature. So I realized today, what am I doing? I've been waiting my whole life for something natural, we call natural. There's nothing natural about nature. It's a hallucination. It's an idle wish, actually. Time, space, process, and form don't exist. They do not exist. It's in our interpretation. It's a misinterpretation. But we insist that everything that happens appear as if it's happening to us, as if we're a product of nature too. And we can only accept the things that nature gives us. This is nonsense. That's why Jesus said, "This world is not my world. Nature is not my world." He said, "I'm going to the kingdom of my Father." That's supernature. That's reality. That's manifestation. Okay, that's everything is instantaneous. As it is here, however, but we interpret it and insist upon this slow motion appearancing, and you know, that slowly changes its appearance. So it seems as though there's some kind of force called nature, some kind of laws and dynamics at play. Those are only inferred, actually. It's quite a tricky illusion that we have come up with here. Very tricky. So don't berate yourself because you think, wow, it seems as though nature's there. Well, we've been very creative in fooling ourselves. But supernature is the answer, okay? Is the answer. Now, we don't have to dispense with the appearance that we see the trees, ground and air, whatever. We don't have to get rid of the appearance. It's only appearance anyway. But supernature is always exactly as we ask for it. Right now, we ask supernature, it's perfect. In other words, the answer is right here. We're not waiting to get there. There's no time involved. There's no quote-unquote time, quote-unquote space, quote-unquote process, quote-unquote form. None of that is involved with supernature. And at some point it's dawning, wow, what I've been waiting for? What a knucklehead, it's just, I could have asked for this, and we just, Jesus said, ask and you shall receive. You're asking supernature. You're asking truth. You're acting in reality. But the way that we have believed in nature, we don't believe that these kind of miracles can happen. We say, no, that's against the laws of nature. So, I mean, Jesus walking on the water is against the laws of nature. No, it's not. There are no laws of nature. It's a consensual hallucination. It's a consensual hallucination. We're all hallucinating together, but that doesn't make it true. Just because we all hallucinate together that there's some laws that God did not create does not make it true. Never will make it true. So, now, we are faced with this trouble because seems like all our concepts, thoughts, experiencing, familiarity is with process. That there's something happening to us, that we're getting something. So there's something to get and someone to get it. And this is the essential trouble that we suffer from, our familiarity. Now, I came across something here. And I will just sort of go over it. This is the great book by Keith Dowman. Translating spaciousness, the Longchenpa's precious treasury of the Dharma Dhatu, which precious treasury of the truth, the way, clarity, precious treasury of clarity about the trouble that we have, because we still are believing we have to get it through nature. Okay, and this is the trouble. Keith Thalman says, to sort of go through this, it must be stressed that no state exists to be achieved. In other words, a state is like an outcome. You reach some sort of outcome. No state exists to be achieved. Thinking that the Dzogchen is a state to be realized, thinking that one, this vision of oneness, for instance, is the state to be realized, immediately concretizes the vision of oneness, Dzogchen, and emphasizes the duality that is to be resolved. It emphasizes the duality. I achieve this state. Here's a state. I've got it. Me and the state. This is mistaken. This is mistaken. So any thought that pure presence is a state, like elation or depression, or certainty or doubt, is to be experientially deconstructed at the moment of its arising, just like every discursive thought, any belief that arises, is to be experientially deconstructed at the moment of its arising. If pure presence were a definable state, there would be a cause and conditions that affected that state, and there would be an effect that was caused subsequently by that state. Okay. If pure presence was caused by certain conditions, like nature conditions, then the formalization of those conditions as technique would allow us to practice it in a process on a path that led to the destination, the goal, which would be a fixed state. That state would appear to truly exist in space-time. But since it would be a product of causality, it would be composite and therefore impermanent and part of conditioned existence, which is another name for samsara, conditioned existence. In the samsaric conditioned existence realm, where zealous ambition is required to attain any worthwhile goal, shades of jealousy and rivalry inevitably transpire, even in the most purified minds. Very true. Because goal orientation accompanied by ambition is generally attended by contention. Constant concern with the stage of the path and the degree of attainment would upset the mind, and finally, the state cannot be attained due to concern whether or not it has been attained. This is very true. Longchenpa is adamant that there is no state of mind to be achieved. To allow the concept of the quote-unquote the state on the grounds that it is the state of non-dual cognition in contradistinction to the dualistic state of perception is to overindulge the intellect. Overindulge the intellect. It is as if the intellect were just waiting for the pronouncement of a state in order to concretize it and then grasp it, to cling to it, to defend and justify itself through it. The thought and concept then either precede or supersede the actual experience. If the concept precedes it, then it is the penetration of the thought by primal awareness from within that allows the experience. If the concept is subsequent to the experience, then dualistic perception has already muddied the waters just by thinking, this is it. This is the state. Then we have lost it, because the state cannot be objectified and reduced to a mere label. If we add insult to injury and to our eureka pronouncement and add an intention to remain in that state, thinking, how can I remain in this state? And we manage to fixate the state and sustain it, then what is stabilized is a trance state. As often quoted, a trance state is the meditation of the gods, or perhaps a samadhi of the Hindu rishis, or a fixation of the Buddhist meditator who has gone astray. The natural state of authentic being, which is the situation when we rest doing nothing, abandoning nothing, nor adopting nothing, has no witness and therefore cannot be established or recollected. The self-sprung awareness that is the reality of that moment has no attributes or characteristics, so how can it be called a state, and who is there to verify the nature of the state? Who is the witness? Okay, so very important here. All of this, it hits home, doesn't it? It is like, wow, this is what we've been struggling with. It's what everyone struggles with. It's like a wake-up call here. Very sobering. It's like a cold shower. So, let it sink in. This is what we give time to let stuff sink in here. Catch our breath. A little practice here that I think what's important to stress is here, what I see from this was it's not something to be recollected. How did I get here? Well, how did I get here? How did I get here? I didn't get there. Nothing ever left. There's not an I coming back to reality. So we don't, we can't recollect, well, how did I get back here? How did I attain this? You know, there's neither a here nor a there to it. There's neither a here nor a there to it. There's neither form nor formlessness to being. Neither form nor formlessness to being. There's neither a state nor a non-state to it. There's neither a state nor a non-state. There's neither nirvana nor samsara. There's neither enlightenment nor delusion to it. Neither enlightenment nor delusion to it. There's neither abidance in it nor non-abidance. Neither abidance nor non-abidance. There is neither location nor non-location to it. It's not a situation of location nor non-location. It's neither visible nor invisible. Neither visible nor invisible. It is neither now nor is it not now. It's not now and it's not not now. It's neither an outcome nor a non-outcome. It is neither a process. It's neither a process, nor is it spontaneous. It's neither a process nor spontaneity. It's neither one, nor is it divided. It's neither one nor is it divided. So, what we're doing is we are working directly here with our expectations, which we don't realize or have been formed by this false belief in nature, in the belief that it's possible to construct a path. In reality, it's not possible to construct a path in reality. It's not possible. It's not possible to say that I'm getting somewhere. I am. Now, every moment is perfectly spontaneously free. There can never be said that there's a path or an outcome. I'm trying to construct an outcome. It's impossible. But we are, this is part of our habit structure that has to be worked on, even though we don't quite understand how deep-seated it is. Our very failure should show us that it is incredibly, you know, tenacious. It is very tenacious. So it is neither speakable nor unspeakable. Neither speakable, expressible, nor unspeakable, unexpressible. It is neither eternal nor non-eternal. The I amness is neither eternal nor non-eternal. The I amness is neither immediate nor delayed. It's neither immediate nor delayed. It's neither absent nor is it present. It is neither absent nor is it present. I amness is neither absent nor is it present. I amness is neither full nor is it void. It's neither full nor void, nor anything in between. I amness is neither temporary nor is it permanent. It's neither temporary nor permanent. I amness is neither dual nor is it non-dual. Neither dual nor non-dual. It's neither insignificant nor is it profound. Neither insignificant nor is it profound. It's neither this nor that. I amness is neither this nor that. Neither this nor that. I amness is neither known nor is it unknown. It's neither known nor is it unknown. I amness is neither existent nor non-existent. Neither existent nor non-existent. I amness is neither open nor is it hidden. It's neither open nor is it hidden. I amness is neither old nor is it new. It is neither old nor is it new. I amness is neither expressed nor is it silent. It's neither expressed. It's neither expressive nor is it silent. I amness is neither expressive nor is it silent. I amness is neither total nor partial. I amness is neither total nor partial. I amness is neither clear nor is it obscured. It's neither clear nor is it obscured. I amness is neither not nor is it not not. It's neither not nor is it not not. I amness is neither confusion nor is it order. neither confusion nor order. Neither. I amness is neither simple nor complex. It's neither simple nor is it complex. I amness is neither true nor is it false. It's neither true or false, nor false nor true. Neither objective, it's not subjective. I amness is neither released nor is it bound. It is not released and nor is it bound. I amness is not real and it's not fake. It's not real nor is it fake. Keep in mind that all these words we're using are actually conclusions that we believe can happen to be grasped as a state, a real state. All right, here's reality. Here's a state of reality that I can grasp. Is neither a state nor is it non-state. So it's not a non-state I can grasp, nor is it a state I can grasp. Reality is neither past nor future. Reality is neither past nor future. Reality is neither dead nor is it alive. It is neither dead nor is it alive. Reality is neither safe nor is it dangerous. Reality is neither a thing nor is it no thing. It's neither thingness nor no thingness. Reality is neither thingness nor no thingness. Reality is neither peace nor is it conflict. It's not peace nor is it conflict. It is not identity nor is it non-identity. Reality is neither identity nor non-identity. Reality is neither triumphant nor is it defeated. Reality is neither triumphant nor is it defeated. Reality is neither substantial nor is it insignificant. It's neither substantial nor insignificant. Reality is neither in focus nor is it vague. It's neither in focus nor is it vague. Reality is neither hospitable nor is it inhospitable. Neither hospitable nor inhospitable. Reality is neither fresh nor is it stale. Neither fresh nor stale. Reality is neither a home or is neither home or nor is it away from home. It's not home and it's not away from home. Reality is not home nor is it away from home. Reality is neither lovable nor is it hateful. It's neither lovable nor is it hateful. Reality is neither exquisite nor is it wretched. It's neither exquisite nor wretched. Reality is neither determinate nor is it indeterminate. Reality is neither everywhere nor is it nowhere. Neither everywhere nor nowhere. Reality is neither pure nor is it impure. It's not pure and it's not impure. So what we have been doing here, this is called phase four practice. Phase four practice. Now only someone who's in tune with phase four is going to say, yeah, I understand this song. I get it. Because in phase four, we are particularly looking at this very issue that it's not a state to be realized. Reality is not a state of mind at all. It can never be. And we're aware that, yeah, there is reality. I can experience it. I've touched upon it, so to speak. And yet I lost it, seemingly. I tried to grasp it. I tried to recollect it. I tried to turn it into something, and even an experience. I tried to turn it into an experience. It's more clear to say it's an experiencing. It's an experiencing. There's no experience of reality. It's an experiencing. So we had an experiencing of it. We tried to turn it into an experience, and then poof, it's gone. It seems to be gone. So what we're doing here is we're simply practicing getting used to the clear mind, the empty mindness, that nothing comes to mind in terms of reality. It's not good. It's not bad. It's not pure. It's not impure. It's not, you know, everywhere. It's not nowhere. It's spontaneous. It just is this. It's this spontaneity. And even it's not spontaneous. Do we just say no, netty, no, to these opposites? And this just like wears away the trouble that we're having. Wears away the trouble. Now, when I was writing these down, I felt some burn. In reading these, I feel very little trouble with it, very little trouble. But it should cause sort of a nervous apprehension, like, what is it? You know, I can't pin it down. What is it? What? It's not what is it. It just is. It's zero dimensional. You might say it's the complete absence, even absence of absence, you see. You could say it's the absence of absence, and even the absence of that, and on and on and on. However we try to concretize it, it's beyond that, and that, and that, and that, and that. So we can say it is the absence of 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 absence. So the non-dual rap, the stage four, phase four rap, is a good way to practice this. I did one video on that. It arose spontaneously on me one morning. I said, wow, this is what's really helpful. And of course, it's so different what we're used to. We're still used to trying to get it conceptually, get it somehow, as if it were, there were some process that produces a product that we get, even if the product is peace. We see it as if it is somehow peace has arisen. You know, it's not like that. So I would say, you know, there's no way to address it directly, except not this, not this, not this. Everything released, 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 released. I believe Longchenpa actually, he has this 12th canto called Released. Released. Very good. And this is another way to practice it. Yeah, we can go through this. So before we do that, keep in mind we're on the verge. We're on the verge here. We're on the verge. Again, Jesus is not coming back as a pill pusher. Okay. So what we need to do is we need to realize that there is no quote-unquote realization. There's no realizer and there's no realization. There is no realizer. There is no realization. The intrinsic nature, intrinsic greatness is already present. All reality is intrinsic greatness without anything taking place whatsoever. That's what it is. It's created as totally functional, total inherent greatness, wish-fulfilling gem, and that's what it is. To think that somehow we're bringing something to that, or we're someone that grasps that, some from outside grasping it, is not true. Reality doesn't need to grasp itself, you know, it doesn't need to. So we can practice, we have to practice this. And you know, if phase four, you realize this is what we have to do. We cannot attach a label to it. We cannot attach a label to it. Now it's easy to say, you know, pseudo-intellectually, oh, okay, I get it. Well, we just don't attach a label to it. I should be okay, I get it. We don't really get it. Because there's a visceral quality to our resistance. Very visceral quality to it. Even deeper than visceral. And so that has to be really gently evaporated through practicing. And the pseudo-intellect is too prideful to do that. It will say, no, I can get it. I understand the word. So there's nothing, there's no realizer and nothing to realize. Okay, I got it. No, but they haven't felt the burn of that. They haven't, you know, full stopped in the burn of this, hearing this and realizing, wow, there's no realizer and there's nothing to realize. See, if you really hear that, it sinks in, you start feeling just like, oh my goodness, you know, oh. It has this, like, you know, punch to it, as it were, just like, wow. That's what the pseudo-intellect is trying to save you from. The pseudo-intellect is trying to save you from just merely this burn, this sense of sort of consternation and indignation and just wow, shakiness, a little bit of jitters. That's what it's saving you from. And this is easy to deal with. It's easy. When you run around the block, you're going to feel the burn, right? And you exercise, you will. So this is just a matter, you feel it in you know, this deep intrinsic burn, like very deep visceral, deeper than that even. Like, wow, no realization and no realizer. No realization, no realizer. So in this, by Longchenpa, all experience is released in the now. All experience is released in the now in luminous mind. All experience is released here and now in luminous mind. An unreleased event is impossible. An unreleased event is impossible. Now this strikes at the very core of our expectations and suppositions and beliefs, because we've been basing it on that there's some unreleased event somewhere and we need to overcome that through the light or something. No, that would mean the inherent greatness of reality is not complete at all, and therefore it's not inherently great. There is an unreleased event is impossible. Conditioned existence, we'll use the term samsara, that's what he uses, conditioned existence. Samsara is released in the now. Samsara is released in the now. Liberated as alpha purity, meaning as just totally pure purity. Pure purity. Nirvana is released in the now. Unformless, unconditioned existence, nirvana. Nirvana is released in the now. Liberated as spontaneous perfection. Appearances are released in the now, liberated in their baselessness. Life is released in the now, liberated in its luminous heart. Mental elaboration is released in the now, liberated in its limitlessness. Formlessness is released in the now, liberated as pure potential. Pleasure is released in the now, liberated in its equalized reality. And when he's saying liberated in its equalized reality, he's speaking of the now. He's speaking of the now, that the now, pleasure is released in now, liberated in its equalized reality. Suffering is released in the now, liberated in the ubiquitous basic expanse. Dispassion is released in the now, liberated in the sky-like Dharmakaya, essential body. Purity is released in the now, liberated in its empty authenticity. There's a description for now. Empty authenticity. Empty authenticity. Even purity is released in the now, in the empty authenticity. Impurity is released in the now, liberated in supreme spacious freedom. Supreme spacious freedom. The levels and paths are released in the now, liberated in the absence of creative and fulfillment stages. View and meditation are released in the now, liberated in non-discrimination. Conduct is released in the now, liberated in the all good. The goal is released in the now, liberated in the absence of hope and fear. Samayas are released in the now, liberated in the supreme reality. Recitation is released in the now, liberated in nonverbal expression. Contemplation is released in the now, liberated in the absence of a field of thought. Affirmation and negation are released in the now, liberated in the middle way. Dogmatic belief is released in the now, liberated in absence of any ground. Authenticity is released in the now, liberated in the absence of any preconception. Inauthenticity is released in the now, liberated in non-critical bias. Karma is released in the now, liberated in its boundless transparency. Afflictive emotion is released in the now, liberated in thorough disinterest. Karmic proclivity is released in the now, liberated in its groundlessness. Karmic result is released in the now, liberated in the discontinuity of experience. Anecdotal method is already released, liberated in self-sufficiency, liberated in the vast sky-like expanse of non-dual give and take. Catharsis is released in the now, liberated in non-repression. Repression is released in the now, liberated in sky-like freedom. Hanging loosely is released in the now, unfettered by the absence of anything to relax. Resting freely is released in the now, liberated by the absence of anything brought to rest. In short, all conscious sensory perception, all that is unconscious or transcendent, everything is already released in the spaciousness of the now, so any attempt to liberate anything anew is superfluous. It is pointless to try and make any effort toward release. Okay, so he's speaking of the now, reality. And we will use some terminology, we'll go over the terminology that's used for the now. Liberated as alpha purity. Liberated as spontaneous perfection. Alpha purity, spontaneous perfection, baselessness, luminous heart, limitlessness, pure potential, equalized reality, ubiquitous basic expanse, sky-like dharmakaya, empty authenticity, supreme spacious freedom, absence of creative and fulfillment stages, non-discrimination, all good, absence of hope and fear, supreme reality, non-verbal expression, absence of a field of thought, the middle way, absence of any ground, absence of any preconception, non-critical bias, boundless transparency, thorough disinterest, groundlessness, discontinuity of experience, self-sufficiency, non-dual give and take, non-repression, sky-like freedom, absence of anything to relax, absence of anything brought to rest. And don't struggle with that. Don't struggle with it. Struggle with it. Don't struggle with it. So, okay. Now we'll go on concluding something that he says here. No differentiation or exclusivity. No differentiation or exclusivity. Just release in the matrix of spontaneity. No union or separation, just release in the matrix of the one soul sphere. No matter what manifests, it is released in the indeterminable matrix. Manifest as form, shining, release just as it is. Audible as sound, vibrating, release just as it is. Perceptible as smell, released in its own spaciousness. Savored as taste, felt as tactile sensations, released in its own space, and thought apprehended, groundless, unsupported, rootless, always released. Liberation in unity, released in the matrix of reality. Non-duality, released in the sameness of object and mind. Self-sprung liberation, released in the matrix of primal awareness. Spontaneous liberation, released in the pure spaciousness of the ground. Multiplicity liberated, released as the one soul matrix. Indeterminacy liberated, released as the spontaneity of the matrix. Everything liberated, released as the heart matrix. the clear light released, liberated in the stellar matrix. Reality released, liberated in the sky matrix. The objective field released, liberated in the oceanic matrix. Unchanging release, liberated in the peak matrix. Release from the first, released in the matrix of potential. Total release, release in the now, liberated in the constantly unfolding matrix. So, don't struggle with it. Don't struggle with it. Just realize it's here. It's available. So don't have to struggle. Truth is true. Nothing else is true. So, these practices are here. They're available. So we don't have to struggle. So, how do I get it? I got to know it's here. And one day we will simply accept. This is how it is. This is how it is. This is how it is. Total release, release in the now. Total release, release in the now. Liberation in the constantly unfolding matrix. 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 No outcome, you see. Everything, all is released. All is released. Total release, release in the now. Total release, release in the now. Liberation in the constantly unfolding matrix. Now, we might think, well, okay, what does that mean intellectually? No, don't even go there. Don't even go there. Just take it that it's self-evident. Truth is self-evident, so there's no reason to figure it out. We're just saying, oh, self-evidency is self-evidency. Okay, self-evidency released in the constantly unfolding matrix. Self-evidency released in the constantly unfolding matrix. So we have a little spiritual buzz going here, which is the goal. You see, he's got to get a little spiritual buzz going here. You know, the modern day stoners, they can get a buzz going pretty easily, right? They pass the pipe around. The hookah, whatever you want to pass around. And they get a buzz going. Okay, pretty simple. But here, we have a spiritual buzz going here, and it's a little more, takes a little more effort on our part, doesn't it? Yeah. Kind of. But not that much. We just listen to some transmission from a teacher. It's a better buzz. Now, it's not a trance state. We're not aiming for any trance state. This is different. It's a self-evidency, totality, total release in the now. Liberated in the constantly unfolding matrix. Liberated in the constantly unfolding matrix. Liberated in the constantly unfolding matrix. See what we have here. To see what we have. Without measuring, just sitting quiet, full stop in the now. Just full stop in the now. How can we get a constantly unfolding, constant self-sprung spontaneity, totality released in the now, release in the now, total release, liberation, the constantly unfolding matrix liberation? How can we get it? Can we get spontaneity? Can we get spontaneity? Can we get spontaneity? Everything is already self-released. How can we get it? It's like we're searching for something, an event that is not self-released, and we say, as soon as we find that, we'll be enlightened because we finally got it. And there isn't any such thing. So our search has to come to an end. Without finding anything. And since there, we never found anything, there really never was a search at all, actually. We're just aimlessly wandering about. So there's not a successful me. There's not some success somewhere. Is there non-success? So there's neither success nor non-success. Neither nor, neither nor, neither nor, neither nor, neither nor. So practice this neither nor, neither nor, neither nor. Maybe I'll type up these opposites and you can practice them on your own. Put them in the description of the video as possible. I'll see if I can do that. Maybe I'll keep me occupied for a little while. So, okay, good spiritual buzz, just full stop in the now. Don't struggle with it. Don't say, okay, how can I apply this? No. Because this is more profound than we realize. And just let it mature, let it mature, let it mature. Saying, well, I did this, I tried to do this for some reason. No, we did not do it for some reason. We tried to come up with an event that was not self-released, not spontaneous. So we're all waiting for something, waiting, 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 something to happen in that way, and it never does. So we've just been waiting in vain. But that doesn't change reality either. So, getting a spiritual buzz going is extremely important, quite difficult if you don't have the push to do it. We can waste our years and lives just taking in entertainment, facts, various trivia. You know, I learned something today. What? Oh, I learned a couple of pieces of trivia, you know. You think, oh, wow, I'm really learning something. I learned some trivia today. That's not a spiritual buzz. The question is, did you get an intense spiritual buzz today? Did you get there? So really, I would say every day you have to be a spiritual stoner. You know, you really be a spiritual stoner. You have to get a spiritual buzz every day. This is not a matter of going to some dispensary and picking up, you know, your stash. That doesn't work. Okay, that's a drug buzz. Jesus is not a drug pusher. Spiritual liberation is not a pill, it's a place. So you have to work on getting an intense spiritual buzz during the day. If you miss out, you know, you're becoming very square. You're becoming a square. people in my generation were terrified of being like their parents, being a square. You know, it's like the most horrible thing imaginable. So they just tried everything possible. You know, I can't be like my parents. And it's probably the same way these days in a lot of ways. So we can't be a square. You know, we can't be a square. We've got to be abstract and, you know, different and trippy and loopy. And, well, you know, we're not going to fit into this rigid, you know, society. You know, young people always feel that way. Society is very confining. Too spontaneity, absolutely. But so we tried not to be. If we thought we were, you know, being square, oh my God, that's terrifying. Well, you don't want to be a spiritual square either, do you? A pseudo-spiritual. You don't want pseudo-spirituality, which is what the world offers. Pseudo-spirituality, that's being very square. So we have to really catch a spiritual buzz every day. A real strong buzz, and you say, wow, I am outside the box. We're really going outside the box here. And so you look for those who help you get outside the box. Longchenpa is one of those that helps you get outside the box. My primary source is Jesus Christ, who is, you know, unsurpassed in getting you outside the box. Unsurpassed. And says stuff that is just like, you know, wow. I do not see you as a body. I do not see you as a body, any of you. And I urge you to see me the way that I see you, and to see all your brothers the way that I see you. And with the greatest of love, I urge you to see it this way. You know, like, wow. Meaning, you say it's possible. You got to do it. So that's a kind of buzz right there, right? Like super challenging. Jesus tends to be very challenging, saying, hey, this is what you need to do. Come on, you can do it. It's like, oh, wow. And so it's a slightly different style on Jempa and Jesus, you know, but both bring the buzz, the spiritual buzz for sure. Use whatever you like. But for sure, in whatever way you can, you have to get that spiritual buzz. And you have to essentially appeal to supernature, reality, instead of nature. You have to realize, goodbye, nature. Goodbye. I don't care what kind of attractiveness you pretend to have, you know. It's the attractiveness of non-existence, which is non-existent attractiveness, actually. So, you know, it's goodbye, nature. Goodbye, nature. You finish with nature, period. You were never even involved, never had a relationship with nature. That's the little bit of fear of waking up. I never had a relationship at all with nature. Wow. And people find each other and hook up and they say, I need a relationship with nature. Can you help me? And you're saying, yeah, I need a relationship with nature too. Can you help me? Oh, sure. You know, let's have a love affair. We'll have a relationship with nature. We'll be able to get in tune with. No, and it's nothing, right? It's really nothing. You're hoping. And you never find that relationship with nature. That's why we never find our true love, actually. Because our true love is what we're trying to find is the love of nature. You know, it's not there. It's non-existent. So, of course, that's why we have frustration. There's never anybody that's ever going to bring you in tune with your love of nature, true love of nature, because nature doesn't exist. You cannot love non-existence. There's no such thing, no such situation. They're just the spontaneously continuing unfolding of the matrix, always released in the now, self-released in the now. So we cannot have a love affair with nature. It's impossible. Many keep trying, and they think that they're fine. You know, probably most of us have been through that. This romanticism, spiritual romanticism, elevated nature. We're going to find, you know, together we are going to find that the pinnacle of nature. We're going to get it. You know, we're going to find the love. Never. No one ever does. they write poems about it. Like, well, if I did find it, it would be like this. If I did find it, it would be like this. There's no finding of it. You can never find what is non-existent. It's like saying, I'm going to fall in love with the dynamics of nature. There are no dynamics of nature, actually. Not really. And so we wrongly say, well, I'm incapable of love then. We see, we draw a wrong conclusion and say, I'm incapable of love because I haven't been able to love nature. No, there's nothing there to love. So we're terrified of love because we think we're incapable of it. We haven't felt it for so long because there is nothing to love in non-existence. But supernature, we love supernature for sure. And it's the glimpses of supernature that we love, and then we project it out and think it came from nature. It did not. But really, loving supernature and hoping that we can then transfer that love over onto nature, onto non-existence, and we can't. So we have no choice but to practice in these exalted ways and get that spiritual buzz, continually get that spiritual buzz, so you just go, wow, and then full stop in that wow. Don't try to dissect it and label it. Don't try to dissect the label, just let it sit there. Wow, this is really a buzz. This is an intense spiritual buzz. Just let it be there. Just let it be there. It's like, I don't know what to think. I don't know what to label it. Yeah, I have no idea how to label it. I can't even put on the label saying no label. I can't put a label saying label or no label or, you know, what label do I put on it? I don't know. And rest in this, I don't know. This is advice straight from Jesus Christ. He says, rest in this, I know. I don't know. Rest in this, I do not know. He says, when you can get to the point where you're full stop in the I do not know, he says, you are very, 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 very close. Very, very, very close. So, just full stop in the I do not know. 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 I don't know what label. I don't know. So when we do these exercises, we're practicing this. I don't know. I do not know. And take it from Jesus. This is very, very close and advanced and very close. And so we're practicing this closeness. We're practicing this closeness. So we're right there. We're right there. But in being right there, we have to make sure that we keep practicing. Now, I was in a church today, Catholic church today, and they're talking about baptism. And they said, how many of you have been baptized? And everybody raised their hand, you know, and I don't raise my hand. I have not been baptized. And I'm a non-Catholic that goes to Catholic church. And then the priest is saying, you see, a lot of you, he's the parable of these two sons. And the father went to one son. He says, could you go work in my vineyard today? And the son says, no, I don't want to. And then later he changes his mind and says, okay, and goes and works all day. He goes to the other son, and the son says, sure, yeah, I'll work in the vineyard. And then he changes his mind and takes the whole day off and doesn't work at all in the vineyard. And they asked Jesus, which one is good? And they, you know, the first one said no, and then reconsidered and said, okay, I'll do it. They did it. So he brings this parallel to those who are baptized, and they say, yes, at baptism. Yes. I have a reservation in heaven, you know, the kingdom. And then they don't do anything. They don't do anything, you see. Now, see, I realize for me, I'm not baptized, you know, so they're telling me I don't have a reservation in heaven. So it's the way I feel is like I have to work 10 times 10 more. Because I don't have any of these tickets that they're handing out. No, I don't have a ticket. And say, wow, I better really work for it then. I really better work for it. And Jesus said, that's the one that's going to be in the kingdom. So I've always stayed away from these rituals and rites that then somehow bestow some authenticity entitlement to you. Entitlement. I always want to feel that, no, I'm not entitled to anything really in that way. I gotta try, 10 times 10 here. I don't take communion. I say, wow, I'm not saved that way either. None of the rites are saving me at all. As I better get it. I better really do the work, or else I'm not gonna get in. I really better really do the work. I better really work in the vineyard, or else I'm not getting in. And what the priest was saying is, and what Jesus was saying is, say, hey, you say yes, you do the rites, do this and this, but you don't work at it. You don't work in the vineyards. You do not work in the vineyards at all. And you're not going to, succeed. So what we're doing here is we're doing the work. We're working in the vineyards here. This is what gets it done. We're not resting on our laurels at all. We're realizing we have a continuity issue here. We have an issue of labeling. We need to get to I don't know. 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 Practice the I don't know-ness. Because there's nothing to know. No knowing is known. No knowing is known. And not known. And known and not known. And no knowing is known. And no not knowing is not known or known. Laboring in the vineyards. Labor in the vineyards. Those are the ones that will be saved from I don't know, right? I don't know, I don't know, I don't know. So it's funny. All my life, I've been feeling like, God, I'm never gonna make it. I don't think I'll ever make it. I gotta work till 2 a.m. What is the time is it now? It's 10:00. That's early for me. A lot of times I'm going to bed at 2 a.m. just continuously working and working and working at it. And I've always felt like, those people who got it made, they got baptized and sacrament, and they've, there's a free ride right into heaven, and here I am, and I have to work like this. And I says, they're so, wow. They're taking it easy, and I'm just slaving away like this. It's rough, it's rough. I have to pay attention. They don't have to pay attention. I have to pay attention. They don't have to be doing this homework, these lessons. They can say, no, I took the Eucharist this evening. I'm good. And I'm saying, wow, I'm not good. I better do these, practice these. Neither this nor that. I don't know. It's neither this nor that, so I don't know. It's neither this nor that, so I don't know. It's neither this nor that, so I don't know. So yeah, I've my whole life I've felt like a laborer, really. Someone who's out there in sugarcane fields, 12 hours a day, every day, cutting sugarcane or something. I felt like a peasant my whole life, absolutely. Just someone who's just, grinding, working without any stop, like a peasant. And you see all these, the bourgeois, they're saying, we don't have to do that, we're having this. We're having our wafer and our wine and that's it, and enjoy life. And I'm out there like a peasant, just working, laboring. Still saying, I don't know, I don't know, I don't know. Neither this nor that, I don't know. Neither nor, I don't know. It's neither nor this nor that. It's neither nor. Neither nor, I don't know. Neither nor, I don't know. Liberation is not a pill, it's a place. It's neither nor, I don't know. So there's another one. Neither nor, I don't know. Liberation is not a pill, it's a place. Neither nor, I don't know. spiritual liberation is we're talking about sidestepping the situation, you might want to call it. It's in the world right now, sidestepping it. Now, that's not permanent liberation, so to speak. It's like attending a seminar by Jesus. Okay, you attend the seminar. It doesn't mean you are liberated, you're released in the now. It doesn't mean you've accepted that you're released, that totality is released, total release in the constant unfolding of the matrix. But it certainly attunes you, you know, in this way. And maybe it does result in that. That's possible. That's possible. But meanwhile, we can dwell in supernature. Absolutely. There's no reason why we cannot dwell in supernature. We're already dwelling here, and there's not even nature. So actually, we are dwelling in supernature right now. It's just that when you dwell in supernature, you realize it. You know, right now we think we're in nature. So to say we can't dwell in supernature is pretty funny, because we already are. It's we're pretending that we're not. That's all. That's like saying you can't dwell in what is real. You have to dwell in pretense, pretending. You know, I know this. So sure, we can dwell in supernature. Absolutely, we dwell in supernature as this masquerade play goes on in this world, and we don't have to keep up to date on it at all. Don't have to keep it up to date on it at all. No. Doesn't matter what labels they've been using. It just neither this nor that. I don't know. Neither this nor that. I don't know. Neither this nor that. I don't know. It's just a practice. Whatever labels they have, whatever their shtick is, you know, okay, say it's okay, it's neither this nor is it not this. It's neither this nor is it not this. It's not this. It's neither high tech nor is it not high tech. It's neither, you know, it's neither the smartphone nor is it not the smartphone. See, whatever the culture, whatever it is, it's neither this nor that. I don't know. 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 This is the spontaneity, self-sprung spontaneity, self-released in the now, self-released in the constantly unfolding matrix. I don't know. There's no determinacy whatsoever. And yet we say, I don't put the label of indeterminacy nor determinacy. It's neither indeterminate nor is it determinate. I don't know. See, I don't know. Rest in that. I don't know. So I don't know. And I don't know, 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 and I don't know that I don't know, and I don't know that I don't know that I don't know that I don't know. And this can bring a buzz to you, and I don't know that 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 I don't know. So using conceptual bridges like this definitely brings a buzz. And since we are so used to using words, we might as well use these word bridges like this into their self-evaporating word bridges. Self-evaporating. We're going on this bridge, and the bridge just sort of evaporating, and it just evaporates. And we realize we don't need a bridge. It's like, wow, it just evaporated, but it's fine. So to use these self-evaporating, you know, practices and expressions. Give up here. Give up there. Give up all here-ness. Give up all there-ness. Abandon all here-ness and all there-ness and relax into that. Give up all here-ness. Give up all there-ness. Give up all here, give up neither here-ness, nor give up any there-ness. Abandon all here-ness, abandon all there-ness, and don't abandon any here-ness, and don't abandon any there-ness. And relax into that. Neither abandon nor not, don't abandon. Neither abandon nor not abandon. All here-ness and all not here-ness, all there-ness and all not there-ness. And neither abandoned nor not abandoned, neither here-ness nor there-ness, nor not here-ness nor not there-ness, and relax into that. So it's like we're walking out on this bridge, and the bridge sort of turns into clouds, and the clouds sort of float away, and it's like that. So keep practicing going out on this bridge. It turns into sort of clouds, and sort of more floating, and then the clouds float away, and I'm just floating, and I don't knowness. The I amness of the I don't knowness of I amness. The I don't knowness of I amness. So definitely work that buzz, work that spiritual buzz. It's both definitely and non-definitely. And neither definitely nor non-definitely. Both and neither both nor neither. And both, both and neither and both. See, this brings this buzz. It's like, whoa, wait a minute. I don't know. It's okay to not, I don't know. I don't know. It's okay. Wow. So you're expressing your I don't knowness. Express the I don't knowness. Express the I know I don't knowness in whatever way you can. Not in anguish. Not as a primal scream. Not doing primal scream therapy. Not in anguish. But in humor, humor, humor. Keep your humor. Keep your sense of humor. Keep your sense of humor. Keep the playfulness, a sort of humorous playfulness about it. Not contrivance, it's contrived at all, but just a smile to it. And a smile, it's funny. It's a little bit funny. Okay, so don't struggle. Don't struggle, 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 and that's it.